What's up, you guys? It's Graham here. So the other day, I was watching a video by Andre Geek about how much money you should have saved up by every age, and that got me thinking. How much money do experts actually recommend that you have saved up by every age, and is that realistic? After all, how much money we need is going to be relative to how much money we make, our lifestyle, and where we live. Like, someone who has expensive taste and a thirst for Starbucks coffee in California is going to need a lot more money saved away in order to live comfortably, compared to someone else in Montana who does just fine making their coffee at home. Now, I know this might be a bit of an odd topic to talk about, especially because I never recommend comparing yourself to someone else. But I think this is a really important measurement to keep track of, because without knowing if you're saving enough, you won't be able to properly adjust your spending, or know when to cut back, or know when you've had enough money invested so that you'll never have to work another day in your entire life if you don't want to. No, seriously, I promise if you watch until the end of the video, you're gonna know exactly how much money you're gonna need to save away in order to live indefinitely off your investments without ever needing to lift a finger or answer to a boss who asks you about the TPS report. So with that said, here's exactly how much money you need to have saved up by every age, my own recommendations when it comes to this, and then what you could do to get yourself back on track if you find yourself falling behind. But first, as usual, you know I'm gonna ask for this, just please gently obliterate the like button for the YouTube algorithm. I think it's a fair trade, I'll help you save and make more money in the span of 15 minutes, and in return, I get a blue like button. So if you wouldn't mind, it means a lot, thank you so much, and let's begin the video. Now to first find out what the experts recommend, we could look no further than our trusty super secret intelligence task force of Google, where there are dozens of articles written with their own idea of how much money you should have saved up at every age, and with that, we should start with this one at 20 years old. But before I get into that, just take a quick guess at what you think the net worth is of the average 20-year-old. Just take a guess. That's calculated by adding up everything they own of value and then subtracting what they owe in debt, and then what's left over is what's called the net worth. So with that, just take a guess at what you think the average 20-year-old is worth. Well, the answer to that is negative $27,000. Yes, you heard me correctly. The average 20-year-old owes $27,000 more than what they have. So just right there, if you're 20 years old and you happen to owe less than $27,000, there you go, congratulations, you are ahead of the average. Now, I will say that the reason for 20-year-olds being in so much debt is rather simple, and it all really just comes down to student loans. Young adults are starting off with little to nothing to begin with, and then going and taking out tens of thousands of dollars worth of student loans. That's why, instantaneously, they could owe so much money before even earning a single penny. Now, because there are not that many recommendations online in terms of how much money you should have saved up by this age, I'm just gonna be coming up with a few that I would recommend every 20-year-old hit by this age, and this is something that pretty much anyone can do. First, by 20 years old, go and get a credit card. The point of this is to begin building up your credit score, and because 50% of your score is made up from your on-time payment history and how long you've had your credit for, this is something you really want to do now, like as in yesterday. Not to mention, having a good credit score is so important anytime you go and buy a house, get any type of loan whatsoever, or leverage your money. So this small step can easily save you tens of thousands or even hundreds of thousands of dollars if you just get it done correctly. All you need to do when it comes to this is go and open up a secured credit card, go and put a few expenses on it every single month, and then pay it off in full consistently by the time it's due. I have another video that I recently did on this down below in the description where I go over exactly what you need to do to get a perfect credit score all for the low cost of $0. Now second, by 20 years old, go and make sure you open up a Roth IRA. Now I know Andre mentioned this in his video, so I don't want people to go and say,
but Graham, Andre mentioned this in his video. You're just copying Andre now. Dislike and sib.
But seriously, it's true. That's good advice, and I've been saying this in almost every single one of my videos for the last, like, almost 4 years now. At 20 years old, there is no excuse for you not to open up a Roth IRA. Just to open up an account with Vanguard, Fidelity, Charles Schwab, or a multitude of the other free brokerages out there. And even if you don't contribute to it, just at least right now, just open one up. It's better than not opening one up. The advantage of this account is that all the profit you make within the account is going to be completely tax-free by the age of 59 and a half, and I'll link to another video I did on this recently down below in the description that's going to go over everything you need to know step by step. So just link is down below in the description. Check that out. The third, by 20 years old, I would aim to have 1 to 2 months of your expenses saved up. This one is meant to be like your emergency funds so that you always have some cash to fall back on in the event you need it, besides the bank of mom and dad. So for example, if you normally spend $800 a month, you should aim to have saved up $800 to $1,600 in a high interest savings account where you could pull from it in the event you need it. And fourth, by 20 years old, just get yourself invested in the markets in one way or another. I think it's so important important to at least begin investing at this stage, even if it's just $100. At least just dip your toes in the water, get a feeling for what it's like, and I have a feeling once you start, you're going to be that much more likely to continue. And if you want a really easy way to do that, just use the link down below in the description, and Webull is going to be giving you 2 free stocks when you deposit $100 on the platform, with one of those stocks potentially valued all the way up to $1,400. So that right there is a really easy way to get started on a totally free stock trading platform that will give you 2 free stocks to put you even further ahead. So overall, at 20 years old, there's not really any like savings or net worth goals that you should aim to hit, but instead, it's really just about setting yourself up with a good foundation to build up from. That includes sticking with good habits, staying out of debt, building up your credit score, saving and investing your money, and of course, smashing the like button for the YouTube algorithm if you have not done that already. But from there, let's go into where you should be at 30 years old. This is where most online articles begin sharing their advice, and overwhelmingly, they all tend to say the same thing. By 30 years old, you should aim to have 1 year of your income saved up. And if we begin researching exactly how much that translates to, we could see that the median annual income at 30 years old is about $40,000 a year. So according to the overall statistics here, if you have $40,000 saved up at 30 years old, you're on track. This also gets a little complicated if, let's say, you double your income at 29, and then all of a sudden, ooh, your income doubled, and now you don't have 1 year of your salary saved up anymore. That's why I think at the age of 30, a few other factors are a better indication of whether or not you're on track, and here's what I think. First, speaking of credit cards, by the age of 30, you should aim to have a credit score of at least 750 or higher. This is going to put you in a really good position financially to borrow money at really cheap interest rates, and it's absolutely doable to do as long as you just have a few years of credit building history. Honestly, I've seen people go from nothing to having a 750 credit score in a span of 3 years just by opening up credit cards, paying them off in full, and never carrying a balance, so it's absolutely possible. The second, I would recommend you become completely bad debt free by the age of 30. This means you've paid off all of your debt or loans that were above a 5% interest rate, you don't have any credit card debt, and besides the possibility of maybe having a mortgage or something at a really low interest rate, you don't really have anything weighing you down. Now third, because I'm sure everyone wants to know, how much money should I have saved up by 30? I kind of agree with the 1x your annual salary at this age as something to aim for. My reasoning behind this is simple. If you graduate college at 22 years old with the average of a $30,000 debt, most likely that's going to take you somewhere in your late 20s to pay off. By which time you would have hopefully increased your income along the way and lived frugally, which means paying off your student loans and having 1 year of income saved up is doable, but could also be quite the obstacle depending on how much money you're making. On the other hand, if you don't have any student loan debt and you get right to work, then having more like 1.5 to 2x your income saved up by 30 could be very achievable. And fourth, by the age of 30, I think it's pretty reasonable to suggest that you aim to save 20% of your income every single month. Again, I really believe a lot of these habits begin in your 20s, like learning to live frugally and saving your money. So with a decade of that under your belt and with hopefully an increasing income at the exact same time, being able to save 20% should be pretty realistic. For example, one of the methods that's worked really well for me is that anytime I end up making more money, I just automatically invest it and then live as though that money never existed and I stay on my current income. Try doing that anytime you get a raise or a promotion or anything. As soon as you get more money, just automatically invest it. It's out of sight, it's out of mind, and that way you'll be able to increase your savings rate without really noticing much of a difference. And now in your 40s, things should really begin amping up. Ideally, your career should be well on its way, all the progress you made in your 30s is beginning to pay off, and now, this is also the time where you should begin seeing your investments do all the heavy lifting for you. Now, most places online suggest that you should have about 3x your annual salary saved up. Now, to be on track for this, it's going to require you to save 15% of your income beginning at the age of 25 years old, and invest that money at an average of a 7% return, which I think is absolutely achievable. But I also think by the age of 40, there's a few other things that we should be focusing on. First, you should aim to max out your retirement accounts every single year. This would include maxing out your Roth IRA at $6,000 a year, or potentially a 401k if that makes sense, or at the very least, your employer match for the 401k or any other retirement accounts that you have available to you. The second, you should also potentially look into buying a house if this is something you're interested in. Now, I'll definitely admit, this one is not for everyone and it's not required, but in your 40s, going and buying a house to settle down in is going to give you a lot more stability in retirement, and you're not going to be at the whims of a landlord who's trying to raise your rent when you're 75 years old because all of a sudden, all the cool kids moved into your area and rents have gone up way more than you ever imagined was possible. Plus, one day that house is going to be paid off, and that brings us to the next one right here. Third, by 40 years old, you should know exactly how much money you spend every single year and aim to have at least 5 to 7 times that amount invested. Now, before anyone loses it and you get angry and you're like,
but Graham, you said to have 3 times my income saved up, and now you're telling me to have 5 to 7 times my spending saved up. Which one is it, Graham? Which one is it?
What really matters the most is not how much money you make, it's how much money you spend. And that is going to dictate how much money you'll have to save up in order to one day retire. The general rule of thumb when it comes to this is that during retirement, you should aim to have 25 to 33 times your annual spending invested in order for that money to last you without ever running out. That means if you're going to be spending $35,000 a year, you're going to have to multiply that amount by 25 to 33, and that means you will need $875,000 to $1,150,000 invested to be able to cover your overhead. And when you're in your 40s, this is the amount that we should be focusing on, not so much how much you've saved relative to your income per se. So that means if you realize your lifestyle is going to be costing you $40,000 a year, you will have to have $1 million invested in order to cover that. Then from there, we just work backwards. Like, if you're 40 years old, spending $40,000 a year, and you already have $270,000 saved up, if you want to retire by 65, you will need $730,000 more, and you have 25 years to do it. Thankfully, though, you have time on your hands, and your investments are really going to do most of the work for you. For example, if you're just able to keep your $270,000 invested and average a 6% return adjusted for inflation, that'll be worth over $1.1 million by the time you're 65, which is enough to spend $40,000 a year in retirement. But now let's assume you're making $90,000 a year at 40 years old and you want to retire with that same income. That's fine, but you'll now need $2,250,000 all the way up to $3 million invested to be able to earn $90,000 a year in retirement, and we do the same calculation working backwards. You'll just need to save 20% of your income every single year, and you could reach $2.2 million by the age of 65 years old, all by saving 20% of your income. These are really the calculations that everyone should figure out as soon as you possibly can, because the sooner you start thinking about this, the easier it's going to be and the better you can plan ahead. This is also why it's so important to save as much money as you possibly can. Like, even if you just make a flat $60,000 every single year beginning at the age of 25, if you're just able to save and invest 20% of that every single year, you're going to have over $2 million invested by the time you're 65. And with that, you will have basically replaced your entire income just from your investments alone only by saving 20% of your income. But now let's talk about where you'll need to be at 50 years old. And a lot of these online articles recommend having 5 times your annual salary saved up. So again, if you're making $90,000 a year, you want to aim to have at least $450,000 invested by the time you're 50. However, by this time, if you're 50 years old and hoping to retire off an income of, let's say, $60,000 a year beginning at the age of 65, well, you may end up actually being behind if you end up following this 5 times your salary rule. That's because in order to be able to retire with $60,000 a year, you'll need $1.5 million invested. And if you only have $450,000 invested, that means you'll have to come up with over $1 million in the next 15 years. If you want to be able to reach that number, you will have to save $20,000 each and every year on top of the $450,000 you invested at an average of a 6% return, and there you go, you will have $1.5 million. That's why if you're watching this right now and you're under the age of 50 years old, start doing this stuff now so you're not going to have to think or worry about this by the time you're older. But since we're talking about all the milestones here, here are the goals that I would recommend that people aim to achieve by the age of 50. One, I think having 5 times your income saved up at this age is good, but ideally I would aim to have more like 7 times your income saved up to put you in a better position for retirement. You would be able to do this by saving more money when you're younger or cutting back on your expenses as you begin making more money. And basically, the sooner you begin planning for this, the easier it's going to be. But two, depending on your situation, you should be about halfway through paying off your mortgage on a primary residence. Some people might have mixed feelings on this and whether or not it's actually needed, but here are my thoughts. I love good debt like this and having a really low interest rate. But I think there's also something to be said about having a primary residence completely paid off. And even though I don't want to pay it off any sooner than I need to, I think it's a good idea as you get older in retirement to keep a paid off property, not try to re-leverage it, don't do any refinancing, just once you pay it off over the 30 years or the 15 years, just keep it paid off. That's going to give you less overhead, you're at a point where you don't need to maximize the value of every single penny, and take the full 30 years to pay it off. You don't have to pay it off early. Now third, by this time, time, you should have a very clear idea of how much money you're going to need in retirement and when you plan to stop working so that you could plan accordingly. If you find out that you're severely underfunded and there's no way possible for you to make enough money to be able to retire without betting on Tesla call options with Robinhood, then I think it's time you really revamp your lifestyle and try to spend a lot less money as you get older. That could include moving to a different location or cutting back on your expenses or really planning around a time where you might not have a full-time income coming in. It doesn't mean you won't be making any more money in retirement, and I have a feeling most of us will continue working as we get older, even if we don't need to. But this is really just all about setting yourself up with the option of not working, whether that be voluntary or out of necessity. And I really believe this is a time where you really got to be taking this stuff very seriously. And finally, by the age of 60, it's set online to have about 7 to 8 times your salary saved up, but again, I somewhat disagree with this, and here are my thoughts. I think by the age of 60, you should really aim to have more like 10 to 12 times your salary saved up. That's because if you start planning ahead and thinking about this when you're 30 years old, you'll be able to easily achieve this just by saving 10% of your income and investing that at an average of a 7% return. By doing that, you'll be able to reach that goal in 30 years just by saving 10% of your income. And if you're able to save 20% of your income, you'll have 20 times your annual salary saved up in that same time frame. It's all about taking small, easy steps now that's going to add up to a lot of money over time. Second, I also think it's a wise idea to have paid off your primary residence, or if you haven't done this yet, you're getting pretty close to it now. This one is going to give you a lot more stability in retirement, and having a home paid off is going to give you a much lower cost of ownership, all things considered. Not to mention, you're also going to have a paid off asset in the event you need to sell it to take the money out or move somewhere else. Third, it's usually said that this is the time where your earning potential may have peaked, so if you find out that you're making a ton of money right now, now is your chance to save as much of that as possible while you still can. And fourth, if you want to, now would be the time where you could begin withdrawing from your retirement accounts without paying any penalties. Remember, all the profits you made within a Roth IRA could be taken out completely tax-free without any penalty after the age of 59 and a half. You could also begin collecting Social Security income as well, but honestly, if you're watching this and you're under the age of 40, who knows if this is still going to be around by the time we're older. The whole thing is honestly just such a mess, so I wouldn't count on getting anything, and if you get anything from this, honestly, it's just a bonus. The whole thing is just absurd, so I would not count on this in the future if you're not within a few years of collecting it anyway. And really from there, the rest is up to you, and these are the goals that I think you should hit in every decade. Obviously, this is meant to be a rough ballpark, and some people are going to be way ahead of this or way behind this, but that's not really important. It's really just more important to realize that if you're not here yet, now is the time to begin working on this. Not to mention, at the end of the day, what really matters the most is how much money do you spend? That's it. It doesn't really matter if you're making $200,000 a year if you're spending $200,000 a year in luxuries. In that case, the person making $60,000 a year but saving $20,000 of it is in a better place financially despite making less money. It's all about starting as soon as you can, even if you're behind, and then working within your means to understand what you need to do to hit your future goals. That's why it's always so important to live below your means, and the less money you spend, the less money you need, and then anything else you save and invest beyond that is just going to be icing on the cake. The best time to start taking this seriously is now, and it's never going to be too late to begin catching up or working harder to achieve these. It all starts with budgeting, saving your money, living below your means, learning to invest, build your credit score, and smashing the like button for the YouTube algorithm. So with that said, you guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. As always, make sure to destroy the subscribe button and the notification bell. Also, feel free to add me on Instagram. I post here pretty much daily, so if you want to be a part of it there, feel free to add me there as on my second channel, The Graham Stephan Show. I post there every single day. I'm now posting here. So if you want to see a brand new video from me every single day, make sure to add yourself to that. And like I mentioned, if you guys want 2 free stocks, use the link down below in the description. And Webull is going to be giving you 2 free stocks when you deposit $100 on their platform. And one of those stocks could be valued all the way up to $1,400. So if you want 2 free stocks, use the link down below. Let me know which 2 you get. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time.